going back a bit further, like where did human come from?
We have a number of sources. Many of the first human beings on this planet came from what we call the second density of plants and animals. There is a natural evolutionary process that goes through the first density of simple awareness of being, earth, wind, fire, and water, and how fire and air teach earth and water to be formed and produce viable life. And then that viable life begins to have a simple awareness. And it's a very long period of time, almost 2 billion years. But some of those beings, higher senses of awareness, graduate to the second density where there's plants and animals, a mind and a body. And these plants and animals eventually go through another evolutionary process, and they can awaken their spirit when their simple awareness from the first density becomes self-awareness, self-consciousness. So they can be graduated to the third density with the spirit complex. So many of the entities on Earth have gone through that natural stage of graduation from first, second, and then to where we are now, third density. But many other entities, in fact, the great majority of entities on Earth now have come from other third density planets like Earth, who also have gone through the graduation of the 75,000 year cycle and have not been able to make it into the fourth density. They've had to repeat the third density, and they've come to Earth to repeat it. And the way that we make a graduation, what we're trying to do right now, and these entities who have come here from other third density planets are trying to do, is to open our hearts in unconditional love, at least in 51% of our thoughts, our words, and our deeds. If we can do that, then we are available for graduation or harvest into the fourth density of love and understanding. So the great majority of people on this planet are trying again, because if you don't have that 51%, if you can't make it the first time, there are as many times as you need to make it available to you. Everybody will eventually make it. But we have a lot of people here right now who are still working on that, and they worked on other planets, and we're here all together hoping we can help each other do that.
There are certain sources that, from what I read or watch, it talks about we are somehow some god came from another planet, not god, but another being from another planet, and somehow modify our DNA to be like this. And based on Darwin's theories, that we just evolved from a chimpanzee, like they are actually going to talk about, like, how do we actually evolve into our actual being?
Well, apparently there's been both of those things that you mentioned are true. Various entities that Ra calls Logoi or Logos, such as our sun, any star you see in the sky, is a very basic creation of love, which the one creator has made in order that all of the rest of the creation might be in existence, all the planets, all the people on the planets, all the various life forms, so that progress of evolution that I mentioned to you could occur. Now, this also occurred on a planet that we call Mars. But at the end, well, the Mars population engaged in what we call warfare. And they destroyed their atmosphere, so it was no longer usable by the human beings on Mars. So there are what we are calling guardians that had the opportunity and the desire to help those of Mars transfer to Earth at the beginning of this 75,000 year cycle of third density, to see if they could continue their progress of spiritual evolution here, because it had to be stopped on Mars. They could no longer live there. And these guardians were called Yahweh, and they were members of what's called the Confederation of Planets in the service of the Infinite Creator, who's a positively oriented planetary minds like Hattan, Atui, Ra, and many others. So this confederation has guardians, that there's a number of them. And Yahweh is a social memory complex or a planetary mind that had the desire to help those of Mars transfer here, and they did. But they thought that they might be able to help them comprehend the law of one and one of its derivative laws, the law of love, which we're trying to learn now. if they genetically altered their species so that they were more intelligent and they had stronger body complexes. And the way they did that was through a process that we would call cloning. And a second way they did it, after the entities were here and had gone through that first change, was they walked among them. And if you notice in the Christian Bible, in Genesis, the gods walked among the human beings on the earth and mated with their women, which sounds pretty outlandish. And is that really true? But apparently it might well be true, that there was another chance to genetically change those of Mars to help them comprehend the Law of One. Unfortunately, other guardians felt that those of Yahweh had gone too far and had infringed upon the free will of those of Mars and tried to do too much for them rather than letting them make their own progress. So as a result, there was a quarantine put around the planet so that any future positive or negative entities that tried to come to this planet would have to have a good reason. They would have to be able to convince the guardians that there was a reason for them to come through. So those of Yahweh were trying their best to help those from Mars, but we haven't gotten into the concept of negatively oriented entities yet. So this is where there are two paths back to the one creator. And we are trying to travel here the positive path of service to others. Like I said, 51% of all our thoughts, words, and deeds being in service to others, trying to help others however we can. There is another path, a negatively oriented path. I must say that all of us exist in what seems to be a separation from the Creator. We seem to be separate from each other and from the Creator, but that is an illusion. We are all one. So we are trying to overcome that illusion as positive entities and enhance the concept of unity. Negatively oriented entities take that sense of separation and then try to enhance it even more so that they are separated from all others and they try to dominate and control and enslave others and take their power from them so that they can use it to make their progression through the densities in the same way. So the Yahweh in the Christian Bible is a wrath-filled God, not the Confederation Yahweh. The negatively oriented entities took that name, they appropriated it for their own use and became what they attempt to use the Mars population as their chosen people. Because the way negative entities work is to establish an elite on a planet like ours, and then hopefully have that elite be able to dominate and control the rest of the planet. Well, that didn't work for them either. But, and I must say right here at this point, the negative path only goes so far. At some point in the sixth density, they have to be able to love everyone as themselves and not just love themselves. And that's not hard for positive entities because we already do that. For negative entities, they have to switch their polarity. They have to flip it and become positive. So that's a long story to let you know how we have both entities that came from Mars, entities that have come from other planets, third density, to try to make the graduation here. And we have entities that we have come from our own second density that are still here trying for their first time, first 75,000 year cycle, to make this graduation or harvest.